Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Sawickipedia. Today we're looking at the different error codes that may be thrown up by your Bosch, Siemens, Neff, Kenmore dishwasher. There's going to be separate videos for each error code, so I'll split these up into a big playlist so you can look at your particular error code without having to look through all the other crap about the rest of the error codes. I'd suggest hitting the subscribe button now just so you can easily come back to these videos whenever you need to. It's going to make it a lot easier to find them for you. But apart from that, we'll get straight into it. The E28 code relates to a problem with the turbidity sensor. So first thing to do, just check your outlet hose, make sure everything's okay there. Otherwise, remove the front panel and the bottom base plate in order to get access to the sensor itself. Just be aware that water's likely to come out when you remove these. So this is the water outlet or drain pipe. Everything looks clear there. Just remember to fasten that clip back up. Otherwise you might make quite a mess. All right, now before we do anything else, just make sure that the power to the dishwasher is turned off, and also the water to the dishwasher is also turned off. If you've got an inbuilt unit, you will have to remove your kickboard in order to access the bottom of the dishwasher. So in order to remove the front panel, you need a Torx T15 bit. You can pick these up from your local hardware store or electronics hobbyist store. So open up the front of the dishwasher and you'll find a total of 6 Torx bits around the back here. There are also a few up the front that holds the control panel on, but you don't need to remove those, so just remove these 6 Torx bits or Torx screws. Alright, once they're out, close the door back up, grab around the bottom at the sides and just pull outwards. Alright, and now you'll have access to these screws at the bottom here. So again, they're Torx T15 bits. Remove those. And then you can just pull this out. Just be careful because it is pretty sharp. Remove this sound deadening material, and now you've got access underneath. So if you've got a multimeter handy, you can also remove some of these connectors and just check the resistance. You should be able to find online what resistances you're supposed to have. That's about it for this video. I hope it's helped you out. The only thing I'd ask in return is for you to subscribe to this channel, which you can find a link to in the bottom corner of this video. There's also another one popping up in the top corner of your screen somewhere around now. So as always, thanks for watching this Wikipedia. Please hit the like button and you can leave me a comment down below. As always, thanks for watching. See you later.